Let's have a look at how the teams line up today. Manchester United without four senior central defenders, all injuries that have occurred in the last week. Lindelof, Martinez, Varane, Evans, all available. So Andre Onana plays behind a back four that has never started together before. Willy Caballero did come on in the second half of Thursday's collapse at Stamford Bridge. Casemiro has played in two Champions League finals against Liverpool in the past when he was at Real Madrid. Can he summon that spirit today? The Brazilian needs a big performance. The other two changes of the Chelsea match is that Marcus Rashford returns to the 11. Antony drops back to the bench. And leading the attack, Rasmus Højlund, who's got 7 goals in his last 8 Premier League games. Due to the chronic shortage of available defenders, 17-year-old Harry Amas and 18-year-old Habib Ogunay are both promoted to the bench from the academy. Jurgen Klopp makes 3 changes from the Liverpool team that started their win over Sheffield United on Thursday. It's the first time since Alisson has been a Liverpool player that the Brazilian misses a league game against Manchester United. The responsibility falls upon Kevin Kelleher again. Ibrahim Konate returns to the bench to allow Gerald Kwanzaa back into the 11 for this one. Andy Robertson returns at left back too. The other Liverpool change from midweek is in midfield. Wataru Endo, he was a doubt for this game with a knock, but he plays in place of Ryan Gravenberch. And Liverpool are at full strength in attack. Mo Salah, the top scoring player in the entire history of games between Manchester United and Liverpool. On the visitors' bench, Jadon Dans, who scored twice off the bench against Southampton in the FA Cup.
It's the preeminent rivalry in English football. The players take the knee as part of the Premier League's No Room for Racism campaign. Well, none of these teams is chasing the Premier League title and the other has the chance to derail them. It adds yet more spice to the tastiest of occasions. We've set off here at the biggest club stadium in the country, Old Trafford, with the rain teeming down from leaden skies. Liverpool in their change kit and on the attack already with Luis Diaz. Casemiro's clearance brought down by the Japanese international Endo. It's the usual breathless start here. And Rashford plays it forward to Bruno Fernandes. And Garnacho looked in an offside position. Flag stays down for now. He tucks the ball away. And the flag then predictably goes up. It's not going to count.
No, but it's great encouragement. That, yes, he was fractionally offside, but offside is offside. And we felt it in our position. We had a good view of it that he had just gone a little bit too early when the ball was released. But, you know, it has to give them that little bit more belief. But here, in moving the bus up the pitch, it didn't go as smoothly as they would have liked, and they had to gamble heavily to get over the line.
Salah has picked out Dominic Szoboszlai. Really important save by the left hand of Onana. Salah, Liverpool continuing to press. Maguire fails to clear properly. Rashford helps him out.
Brilliant stop by Onana.
Robertson. Salah. Szoboszlai.
Yeah, I mean, maybe earlier in the season that might have gone in. He's not been as accurate, but that was very close.
Robertson and steered goalwards, but not guided on target by Szoboszlai.
Yeah, I just wonder whether there was a little slip in the process and Szoboszlai couldn't get himself in the right balance to make the right connection he wanted, because it's really well worked as far as Robertson and... Yeah, you would have expected something better from him.
Second in the table, a point behind Arsenal after the Gunners' victory at Brighton yesterday. Level on points with Manchester City. Robertson. And Nunez, and it's Diaz! Turning, sweeping and scoring. And whilst it doesn't entirely silence Old Trafford, Liverpool's travelling support sees to that. It certainly marks a change in the mood.
it's hard sometimes to stay with your man. And just watch what happens here with Wan-Bissaka. Nunez just steals a yard on him to get the flick on. And of course, you've got somebody loitering far post, and it's Luis Diaz in this case. And all he had to do was just get solid contact on this effort, and it was likely to find the back of the net. I mean, even though there were three back on the line, as long as he got pace behind it, he was pretty much bound to find it. And yeah, the little escape from Nunez.
Bruno Fernandes, Casemiro, right across the face without a telling Manchester United touch.
Well, I remember thinking at one stage there, should Kelleher be reading that and should be a little more active off his line, because they seem to get the timing just right, and Casemiro can't do any more than that. I mean, it's a lovely little cushion header back across the six-yard box, and you would have thought somebody would have been taking that risk more.
Mistake by Cambuala, and it's allowed Darwin Nunez in. And Cambuala got back to make a challenge.
Yeah, well done.
Because he knew the mistake was there, and he had to make up for it, and he did just that. Just glanced off his shin, and obviously he knew that Nunez had to cut inside.
McAllister. So many viable options. He's chosen Diaz. This is Salah, and that was another.
Yeah, I can understand though why he decided to hit it first time. And this has been kind of the story of Manchester United's season, that getting caught a little higher up the pitch and opposition getting behind their midfield. And it was, the pick out was perfect on his left foot, but he couldn't quite find the corner. And it's not the most difficult from Onana. It's almost like a little TV save.
And Nunez! Flag now goes up on the far side as we move into 2 minutes of Lex's stoppage time.
I mean, I think it's too easy at times as well for the fullbacks. Look, I mean, it's Robertson who plays this, and he is slightly offside Nunez when it comes back, and it did palm it away again.
Quansah. And that's careless from the youngster, and Kelleher was off his line. Manchester United are back on terms in the most unlikely of fashions. Quansah might well hang his head. The youngster caught out. Bruno Fernandes taking the widespread acclaim.
Well, that is a similar tone to Liverpool's last visit here. And Quansah obviously will be sick of the fact that he's just made a bad, bad decision here, and he was just too casual. And you have to commend that. He's not been having the greatest day, Fernandes. But why take a touch and look for support? Why not just have a look up and see if the keeper has drifted out? And Kelleher had. And that's a beautiful finish from Bruno Fernandes. Absolutely brilliant, but Gerald Quansah has just had a momentary nightmare.
And how close to the end of the season we are. Maynou. Rashford. Casemiro now. Garnacho deflected. Corner kick.
And all of a sudden, Manchester United have come to life. Deflections are all the rage in recent times.
And that's an awkward ball in, causing all sorts of consternation. Devilish to defend.
It's that horrible one for a goalkeeper, because you don't know whether there's going to be some contact on it. And he must have thought Casemiro was getting there, so credit to him for anticipating it getting to him.
Liverpool's turn to be on the ropes. Read by Szoboszlai for Liverpool. And the break is on, and Liverpool have the numbers here. Five of them. Salah. Diaz. Nunez.
John, I cannot believe that Nunez has decided to knock it across the six-yard box and not look for Szoboszlai. It was perfectly positioned. And once Manchester United got caught here, it looked as if they were going to get the severest punishment. And everything to this point was looking quite rosy. And look at Szoboszlai. All he has to do is just feed it back and he's got an empty net. I mean, are Liverpool going to repeat what happened on their last visit and let United off the hook?
Bruno Fernandes. No conviction about those in red. Rashford. Teased in, and Kelleher juggles and collects. Wan-Bissaka. Maynou! A career-defining moment, perhaps. For 18-year-old Kobbie Maynou. Liverpool in trouble. Question mark against the title hopes. And the youngster from down the road in Stockport has raised the roof at Old Trafford.
Well, this is sensational. I mean, we know this kid has huge potential. And he's shown some delightful football in midfield. But to come up with something like this is just absolutely sensational. I mean, to have the little turn and the awareness of what was around him and what he might be able to produce. And it doesn't come any better than that. I mean, Kelleher's never getting there. One touch, swivel, far corner. And for Jurgen Klopp, that don't impress him too much.
Spells trouble. It's Elliott. And ooh. Harvey Elliott, it's a penalty.
Oh, this is really clumsy. This is panic from Wan-Bissaka. Absolute madness. He's completely panicked and just thrown himself and given an excuse to Elliott. Oh, dear.
Trailing to your greatest rivals. And time fast running out. It's Salah, and it is two apiece at Old Trafford. Maybe with power to add.
Well, when you reflect back on Thursday night against Sheffield United and his substitution and the anger at the fact that he was taken off, it looks like he's just bottled it all up and used it to find the back of the net now. He's obviously moved on from all of that. And now this is another big plus in Liverpool's favour. And who knows what way this might swing from here.
27 goals in the final quarter of an hour. More than a third of their total. And they won't care if it's the late, late show. Mason Mount is on in the wake of that goal. Anthony.
Well, credit to Robertson, because at least he stayed there and Anthony knew that he had to get a shot away.
Late deciders. There won't be much more beyond this. It's Robertson. It's Maguire. It's Elliott!
Well, he can't hit it any better than that on his weaker side.
And that does it. A setback for Liverpool, not as severe as it might have been. They are the ones that blinked and failed to return to their perch at the top. Arsenal remain at the summit after a topsy-turvy game that Liverpool seemed to have within their grasp and well under control when they led at half-time through Luis Diaz. And then Quansah's mistake, Bruno Fernandes from distance, 1-1. Kobbie Maynou with a worldie for 2-1. And 6 minutes from time, the calmest of penalties from Mohamed Salah. Rebecca, this certainly hasn't let us down. Liverpool came here hoping to walk the line, and if he'll excuse the Nashville influence, they were engulfed in a second half Manchester United ring of fire.
Hi there, I'm Rebecca Lowe, studio host for NBC's coverage of the Premier League. Don't forget to hit subscribe to watch more videos all season long. And for even more Premier League content, from original series to live matches, head over to Peacock. And be sure to tune in for Premier League mornings every weekend on USA Network and on Peacock. We will see you there.